No takers here, because there's epidermis on it, right?
Yeah. So this one, at first glance, kind of reminded me of like a ganglion cyst, although there's more like little kind of like villus type things in there.
Sure.
And it's more kind of hyperplastic. So I needed Whedon to kind of help with this, but I felt like what fit best was a metaplastic synovial cyst.
That would probably work too, actually. This is, I know these are all, Dr. Ferringer's slide set. So I'm totally, these are all new to me. I just basically looked at them today. So, but yeah, I think that the clinical does, make a difference there, and there certainly can be a lot of overlap. So this is labeled as ganglion cyst. A lot of times when I see a ganglion cyst, it's just a dense collagen, dense regular connective tissue, dense collagen lining, with no actual lining cells, so it's really a pseudocyst, if you will, although occasionally you can have some synovial lining in it. They may be filled with kind of bluish mucin, myxoid material, which is basically synovial fluid, but a lot of times that's totally washed out, like is the case here. It's all washed out during processing. Sometimes that can leak into the surrounding tissue and give you zones that look kind of myxoid or loose and mucinous. It just varies from case to case. This case, whatever we want to call it, is definitely very irritated and inflamed. The wall, instead of being just dense regular connective tissue, the wall is basically granulation tissue and fibrosis, really thick layers of it. So it could be a ganglion cyst that's been ruptured. A lot of times people try to smash their ganglion cysts, like with a real heavy book or something, and get them to rupture. So it's a ganglion cyst that could have been ruptured or manipulated. The other thing that can look just like a ganglion cyst, particularly when they have this thick, robust granulation tissue, is a bursa, a chronic proliferative bursitis. Comes from a bursa that gets inflamed and gets, like, you know, cycles of irritation and reactive change over time. And both ganglion cysts and inflamed, irritated bursa can get this, like, deposits of fibrin in the center. So these that can look kind of like little tiny oval bodies that are loose floating in the middle, or they can be attached and kind of have a villous appearance, like you mentioned. But they're actually not really made of much cellularity. They're pretty much all dense fibrin, sometimes with a little bit of histiocytes and fibroblasts kind of starting to organize like you have here. But your point is well taken, that a metaplastic synovial cyst, which is basically the idea, is that if you have a foreign body, you can get synovial metaplasia around it. You particularly see this around like breast implants. The body kind of reacts and makes this kind of synovial-like pseudo lining that kind of walls off the foreign material, whether it's a breast implant or something else. And then you can get, if that material comes out, what the wall of that looks like is very much similar to the pattern that you see in an irritated ganglion cyst or an irritated bursa. To me, the only way to tell is really the location and what the surgeon thought it was. If it connected down to the joint space, it was probably a ganglion cyst. If it sits where a bursa normally is anatomically, it's probably an irritated bursa with kind of granulation tissue. Or if there was a foreign body there, then it could be a synovial, a metaplastic synovial cyst. So great, that's a good differential. So this is a very robust example of reactive change in a ganglion cyst in this case. And again, there's no lining here, right? It's just granulation tissue, and then all of a sudden you got some fibrin and empty space. Good job.